Hey guys, it is Ty here coming to you with another youth update this week and a few things that I want to let you know about. The first one is if you painted pottery at the girls' night a few weeks ago, that is ready here at the church. And so we have that. You can come pick that up. I'll also make sure that it is at youth on Sunday night if you want to just pick it up there. So that'll be perfect. The next thing is that Cedar Canyon's one-way camps are officially canceled for August and September. I know for many of y'all that is devastating, and for me it is too. Being a part of those conversations was hard, but one of the things I want to remind you of is each year at the end of camp, we have conversations about what it looks like to go home and to continue to live this Christian life, continue to have these moments where you're surrendering what is going on in your life to God and where you are finding time to be at peace and to be present with the Lord. And all of those are still true. All of those things that we encourage in you are still present and opportunities for us. And so I'd really just encourage you to press into those to create spaces. Parents, if y'all need to help with that, to create space to just really take the time to be present to what God has for you. So with that, one other thing that I want to let you know of is we are going to go ahead and have the information here in the newsletter about the Buttman camps. So Buttman is another Methodist camp within our conference. It's actually even a little bit closer. And so they have a junior high advanced camp and a high school advanced camp. Both of those, the dates are right here. I will be at the high school advanced camp. And so just let me know, please, as soon as possible. If you are interested in that, I can contact you, get you more information, and get you signed up for one of those if you're interested. Next thing is that this fall, in October, hopefully, we're going to be starting something new that I'm really excited about. And these are discipleship groups. We're going to call them DGs, and it'll just be kind of a thing. But there's four of those that we're going to be launching for four specific groups to be able to jump in during the week that have leaders and host homes and different things like that. And so be looking for more information on that. If you have questions about what those might look like, or maybe how you could help either host and be a host home or lead and be a leader for one of these groups, that would be great. So reach out to me, but more information on that is coming soon. And then no youth tonight. So continue to remember that in July, we do not have youth on Wednesday nights, and we are continuing on Sunday nights. And lastly, that this Sunday night, the youth will be at the Brooks House from 6:30 to 8:30. So we hope to see you there. As always, if you have any questions, let me know. This is a crazy time. And so we're going to be looking at how we can integrate some safer practices into youth on Sunday nights, but then also have stayed away from the space that I'm in right now that I would love to be sharing with y'all just because of size and because of space. And so continue to pray, continue to encourage your students, and just continue to pour out all the kindness and the peace that we can in the midst of all of this craziness. So thank y'all. Have a wonderful week, and we'll see you later. Bye.